pleading for compromise.
If Australians don't know what they're voting for, they will vote no.
That's Voice supporter and former Indigenous Social Justice Commissioner Mick Gooder. The compromise? Changing the wording of The Voice to win more votes, as polling shows support for the Yes campaign has slipped 5% in the past month, while opposition has surged.
If this is a simple exercise of removing advice to executive government, let's do it, because in reality, that issue can be fixed up when the legislation that will come after a Yes vote. To me, it seems a small compromise to make here.
Those calls coming under fierce attack today from fellow Yes campaigner Noel Pearson.
This is what little Mickey Good has done here. He's wetting the bed far too early in the day. He can't separate compromise from capitulation.
Noel's a wonderful Australian, but by his own admission, he's got a pretty sharp tongue. He went overboard in relation to Mick Gooder.
I'm not going to be bullied into changing my position, and I caution that the Australian population won't be bullied into voting yes.
But Noel does acknowledge the Yes campaign has issues.
There's been a lot of heavy weather, a lot of confusion, a lot of adverse media. The campaign proper is yet to start.
The Yes campaign hoping a $10 million war chest, a bunch of merch and advertising, and new head of operations, Liberal Simon Frost, will turn the ship around. As the AFL, the NRL and Rugby Australia this week joined other major sporting codes formally backing The Voice.
I think it's counterproductive because most of their fans are really scratching their head as to why the elites within the sport, particularly the elites involved in the administration of the game, are taking a position in relation to The Voice.
So as the referendum race tightens, should compromise be on the cards?
Imagine what would happen if the whole Australian population voted for this. We will truly wake up on that Sunday morning, the day after the referendum, to a new Australia. So that's what keeps me going.
Well, Thomas Mayo is part of the referendum working group. He joins us now. Thomas, some of the language used today has been pretty fierce. Do you think that divisions in the Yes camp could ultimately undermine the vote?
Well, I think we're months away from the referendum itself. The parliament itself will be debating the bill that takes us to a referendum. And so this is just a normal thing, you know, that people that have done a lot of hard work to bring this opportunity about are going to have disagreements from time to time. But I'm really looking forward to the campaign proper taking off. And I think the question, though, is going to be the same no matter what. And it's a simple matter of recognition and consultation of Indigenous people.
What's your view on Mick Gooder's line that we need compromise? The compromise needs to happen to get the yes vote over the line.
Well, I think we've already had a lot of negotiations. I'm part of the referendum working group that had the discussions with the government. The words are very important, and I think that the constitutional experts, eminent constitutional experts, the Solicitor General, the committee itself that has spent 6 weeks looking into this and taking submissions and a wide range of evidence from a wide range of people have settled on the current wording. And I think that the wording is, I agree with them, that this wording enhances our democracy, that it simply gives Indigenous people a voice, not a third chamber, not a right to veto, but just the simple ability for Indigenous people to choose representation and to be heard. And so I'm confident in the existing words.
Are you worried, Thomas, about the polls?
Well, there's a lot to lose if this referendum should fail. It's not going to just be status quo, which in itself isn't good enough, with the wide gaps between Indigenous and non-Indigenous people in life expectancy and health and education. Obviously, what we're doing right now isn't working. But it won't just be status quo if we fail, and that's what really concerns me, because it'll actually make things worse. Indigenous people will have officially been dismissed as for our existence, for our long heritage and proud culture, and the fairness of having a say will have been dismissed. So I do believe that the Australian people do believe in a fair go. I have faith in them, even though we've taken a bit of a hit in the polls lately. And I think with the more information that they have before them, we're going to see a positive result when the referendum comes.
So you've released a myth-busting guide to The Voice this week. What is the biggest myth that you're busting?
Well, one of the biggest myths is that we already have a voice by having Indigenous members of Parliament. But those members of Parliament, though, you know, they do come from Aboriginal communities and, you know, and are Indigenous people, they represent electorates and they represent political parties that have chosen them to speak to those policies. A voice will be very different. It'll be people chosen by Indigenous people who understand our culture, who understand the problems that we have and know the solutions. Because they live and breathe, you know, those issues every day, and will be held accountable by Indigenous people ourselves, and this will be a massive, you know, difference to it will really be the key to closing the gap is having a voice.
Thomas Mayo, thank you so much for joining us tonight.
Thank you.